We are now recording. All right, guys, welcome. This is Russ Armstrong with the Digital Ops 2 Traffic Training Webinar. And tonight's topic is solo ads. So we're going to be discussing solo ads, how to find your solo ad provider through the array of multiple solo ad providers, ways that you can make connection with them, how to test with them, etc., how to grab your links out of the back office, tag them, etc. So this actually should probably be about an hour-long webinar, unless you guys have a ton of questions. It's not going to be like my Facebook webinars where they were almost, I think each one of them was almost 2 hours long. So a little bit about myself for people that don't know me, and hopefully you guys will keep joining us on these webinars so you'll really get to know me. You'll probably end up getting sick of me after a while. My name is Russell Armstrong. I go by Russ. I'm a retired fire officer of 31 years. I've owned 11 successful businesses since the age of 18. My parents were entrepreneurs, so I learned at a very early age how to be a business person and how to own a business. Plus, I had a full-time career on top of that. I currently own 4 online businesses, actually 5 if you include the coaching and me being an affiliate with Digital Altitude. That would be, I guess, 5 and maybe even 6. I have taught students for over 33 years, both in person, online, etc., through video, etc., and also I have now taught, actually that number is changing, I have just about hit the 1,000 student mark with teaching people the internet marketing. So I have a lot of experience in this. I love to teach people, I love to show people how to make things work, how to work it in their best interests. And also, hopefully, I show you guys things of what to avoid, which are big pitfalls that I may have run into in my career as an online marketer. I will tell you right off the bat, you're going to make your own mistakes, and no one is invincible on that. I'm just going to try to teach you things that I did so you don't do them, so you don't duplicate them, and then the things that worked for me, so hopefully you do duplicate them and can run a successful business. But welcome to Digital Altitude. I think this is going to be an exciting journey for you. You got to be willing to roll up your sleeves and get to work. But remember, it's your business. The only person that's going to stop you in anything you do, whether it's Digital Altitude, whether it's any kind of work, whether it's in your personal growth, the only person really that ever is going to stop you is yourself. Okay, so that's kind of my words of wisdom. Because you know, we all want to find excuses. Well, that person stopped me from doing this, or this company stopped me from doing that, or whatever. You know what? It all boils down to ourselves. We allow those things to happen, and we give up. What I want you to be is strong. You're going to roll up your sleeves, and you're going to find a way around what is blocking you. And that is what I try to embrace every single day. There are days that, you know, I just want to sit back and say, you know what? I'm tired of fighting this fight today. But I don't. I get up and I figure out what I need to do, and I get through whatever is causing me the issue so that I can move on, okay? But it all boils down to yourself. So always think of that no one else stops you but you. So eliminate the barriers and let yourself go and get your business running and become successful, okay? So let's see here. Let's go now. Let me get rid of this screen. I run multiple screens, so every once in a while I forget where I'm at. Okay, so let's look at right now solo ads. We discussed solo ads. So the thing I'm going to show you today, I'm going to show you a couple things here. So let me show you this first. So this is what I will email to you. But I need you guys to email me and ask for this stuff, okay? Because I have no way of sending out a massive, I can send out a massive email to everybody registered on this class, but the problem with, I can't add anything to it. So you have to send me an email and ask for this information. What I'm going to show you first is a solo ad provider list. Now, this is a list of providers that I have pulled together. This is either people that I have personally used, or people that have referred these people to me, have given me these links. So they're reputable providers, They're good. It's hard to find the reputable provider out there. You got to search for them. So this is a list of solo ad providers. It has their name. It has their link. What kind of solo ad, you know, whether they do a solo ad. There's actually three solo ad directories in here, which have multiples, if not hundreds, of solo ad providers available to you. And then also, if you go down here to the lower part of the page, and we're going to have another webinar on this, there's a link here, or several links here, for banner ads. So if you are interested in banner ads, we're going to be doing a webinar on banner ads. But not tonight. So anyway, I'm going to be giving you guys this list of solo ad providers. And I don't think, actually, you know what? I can see if you guys can access this. Looks like I can drop a file in here. So let me, hold on a second. Hey, you learn something new every day. All right, so we're going to try this. I'm going to drop a file in here. Okay, so now in your control panel on your computer screen, the one that you accessed for this video or for this webinar, there now should be a file there that you can grab. It's a PDF file, so you should be able to grab that and utilize that file. That's the solo ad provider. Great. People are telling me they got it. It's there. Okay, great. If for some reason, like you're on a phone or something like that, and you need me to email it to me, then again, just make sure you email me and I will send you out the link as well, along with the recording. Now, here's another question for you guys. Let me make sure everybody's hands are down. Let's see here. How many people have Microsoft Excel on their computer? Yes, Natalie, it's in the handouts. How many people have Microsoft Excel in their computer? All right, raise your hand if you got it. Okay, so this is the next treat I'm going to give you here. Let me grab the right file here. Hold on a second. Actually, here, I've got to shut off Skype for a second. I got my Skype blows up every single day. Okay, let me grab this out of the way. Okay, so I'm going to give you a template here. Now, this is in an Excel spreadsheet. So if you do not have Excel, so that's also in the handouts, download that. If you don't have Excel, this is something that you can do. If you have a Gmail account, then in a Gmail account, you would also have access to a Google Drive. So what you can do if you do not have Excel is you can open up your Google Drive, and you can, what I would do is just create a new folder. So I'm just going to create a new folder and just call it, I'm going to call it test, because I've already got this form on my folder or on my drive. But I'm going to open up a new folder here, okay? And then what I want to do is I want to add I want to upload a file. So I'm going to click on upload. And then what I'm going to do is, and you guys would have this here, so just download this file, this Excel spreadsheet. But if you don't have Microsoft Excel, you can't open it. So what you can do is download, let me find it here, hold on a second. Let's see here, it's the ad tracking sheet. All right, so what you're going to do is you're going to take this Excel template, just find it in your downloads, and you're going to open it up here in the Google Drive. So what it'll do is it will convert this form over to a Google Drive sheet. So you don't have to have Excel, you'll just have to access it on Google Drive. So is that helpful to you guys? Raise your hand, let me know. That helpful? For those of you that don't have Excel, great. All right, perfect. I bet you guys didn't know you could do that. All right, see? You gotta learn something new every day that keeps your mind fresh. Perfect. All right. If you're having trouble opening the file, it may be because either you have an older version of Excel, but just try the method of putting it up in a Google Drive first, Rihanna and see, or Raina, and see if that helps. If not, email me and maybe I'll just have to send it to you a different way. And just see. It just depends on what version of Excel you have, although I picked a version that most people should be able to use. But anyway, you can give this a try. This is another way you can add it on here. Now, looking at this here, this is a tracking sheet that you all are going to have, and you all can see this, I think. So this is how it works, is I have formulas built in here. This is for you to be able to test or for you to be able to track your, let me just get this form spread out far enough that you guys can see it. This is so you can track your, I got to move that out of the way. All right, you can track your ads. And the way this works is, first thing you put in here is you put in your date you purchased your ad, who you purchased it from, the URL that you purchased it from, in other words, the sales page you went to buy their package. Then you're going to ask, or then you're going to put in how many clicks you bought, how much you paid per click, what is the expected date that the ad will run, okay? In other words, when you buy the ad and they say, hey, it'll take a week for your ad to run, okay, so just calculate it out. It'll run on such and such date. The tag you'll apply, and I'm going to discuss tags here in just a little bit, but that's a tag, a unique ID that you're applying to your link, so when it comes into your back office, you're going to be able to say, okay, I know what ad that came from. You're going to be able to track the people to say that ad worked or that ad didn't work. And we're going to discuss that in just a little bit. Your unique clicks received. So in other words, if I bought 200 clicks, I want to make sure I'm receiving 200 clicks. And I'll show you where to look for that. You want to document the number of leads you got out of there. So you want a minimum of 21% when it comes to click to lead ratio. So I want 21%. That means I should, out of 200 click ad, I should have a minimum of 42 people opting in. Now remember, an opt-in means that's someone that's given their email address to look further. That's all they've done. They're just giving their email address so they can see more about the product. All right, they haven't bought a thing. Then what I'm looking for is a 5% conversion rate. So this is from leads to buyers, how many buyers are you getting? And this formula will calculate it out. So you put in the number of buyers, the $1 buyers you have, and it'll calculate out what the percent of conversion is. I'm looking for 5%. That's an industry standard. Then I'm going to list in here what the cost of the ad was. And then I'm going to list in here as my commissions come in on that ad, and they're going to start out low because you're doing a $1 sale. So if you're a climber member, you get 43 cents. If you're a Walker member, you get less than 43 cents on the dollar. So you would put in the total amount you have currently earned on the ad. So let's say you have currently earned, let's say you had 10 people come in, all right, which is a really good high percent, that's a 23% conversion rate, that's unheard of. But let's say you had 10 people come in and all of them came in and your commissions on that, because you're a climber member, are 43 cents. So that's $4.30 that you have earned so far. So see what this does? This tells you that I am still in the hole $125.70, okay? And I have a minus 96.69% return on investment because my ad cost me more than I'm earning, okay? But now let's say 14 days passes by and let's say all 10 of those people go up to the $37 offer, okay? Not one of them backs out. They all go to $37. That's going to be $16.15 to you if you're a climber. So that's going to be, 10 times the 16, 10 times the, 16.15. So that's going to be, $161.50. So now I would update this information. So 161.50. And I would hit my button there, and now I have a return on investment. I have a profit of $31.50, and my return on investment percentage is 24.23%. So then, let's say even one of these people goes to, and I'm a climber member. Let's say one of these people goes to Rise. So I have the 31, which is what, $720, I believe, is what you clear on Rise, because remember, you're paying a percentage to the coach that sold them Rise. So let's say I'm adding now the 720 to that 3150. Oops. Oh, I didn't want to do that. See, I'm trying to run my calculator with my other hand here. 3150 plus, what did I say, 720. Okay, so now my return on, or my commissions, my the money I'm generating here is now up to 751.50. Okay, so now this will calculate out. Now my return on investment, I have made in profit, because I paid for my ad, I've made in profit $621.50, and my return on investment is 478.08%. Does that start making sense for you guys? You guys understand what I'm talking about there? Tracking is incredibly important to be able to do, and so you want to make sure that you are definitely, you know, tracking your ads here. You're going to get some ads that you'll place and you're going to pay $130 and your return on investment is going to be zero. Okay, that's just life. That's the way advertising works. I wish I could guarantee advertising. If I could, I probably wouldn't be doing this webinar. I'd probably be sitting on my own island somewhere, you know, watching my yacht offshore, and, you know, I'd have more money than I would know what to do with. All right, but you know, no one can guarantee traffic. No matter what they say, no one can guarantee it. But what you're looking for is by testing, you're at least going to know what is working and what is not working. Because if something isn't working, get rid of it and go to something that is working, or go and test something new to see if it works. Okay, you've got to stay on top of this stuff. Otherwise, it'll eat your business up if you don't track it. All right, so everybody will get a copy of that sheet, and I'm hoping that that everybody has already gotten it. If not, again, you know, send me an email after the webinar is done. I'll send you obviously the recording, and I'll send you this tracking sheet. So it's well worth it to have it here. So let's get rid of that. Actually, we'll open it up, and we'll just keep it there. Okay, so let's go back to our digital altitude. So now, in digital altitude, everybody real quick, raise your hand, and everybody should be raising their hand on this one, but everybody real quick, raise your hand if where it says my marketing, you're able to open that. Okay, raise your hand if you're able to open my marketing. I want to see everybody participate here. We got 55 people on this, so I should see 55 hands up. That's to the people that aren't paying attention. I can tell right now, I can see who's paying attention. All right, so Jason, your marketing is locked. Okay, so real quick, anybody else with their marketing locked, please message. Let's see, my marketing is not unlocked. Okay, all right, and that's Taylin, I think. Okay, anybody else whose marketing is not unlocked? Because you need this marketing unlocked in order to get anywhere. You cannot promote with the marketing locked. So anybody else there with their marketing locked, put your name, or put that your marketing is not unlocked in the question area. All right, Matt Johnston, mine is locked. Okay. All right, Marie Davis, yours is locked. Okay, so this is what I want you guys to do. I want you to look. You're going to go over here to my business, and you're going to go over here to my rank. Now, what you should be looking for is the first line here that says affiliate. That may say inactive. All right, if this says inactive, over here to the right, there should be another link that says activate. You need to activate your links in order to be able to promote. Otherwise, you do not have access to your marketing links. So anybody here that has said that their marketing, my marketing area, is locked, please go and look at this right now and see if it's something you just need to activate. Now, you can activate it at the end of the webinar. You can activate it right now real quick. Everybody pays this fee. It's a $17 per month fee for the affiliates. I'm an Apex climber, and I still pay the amount. So everybody pays this. It's required for us to have people pay for this. Because the United States here requires us, if we're an affiliate-based program, we have to have some way that people pay a monthly fee for the affiliate links themselves, and it's a non-commissionable fee. So us as members, if our downline pays for it, we don't earn a commission off of it. So we made the price as low as we could, but everybody has to have that active. If not, your marketing is not active, you cannot access your links. So double check that and make sure that that is active, okay? If once that is active, your marketing area here should unlock for you, okay? So make sure you go and do that. I'm going to go ahead and clear some of these people out of here. All right, so Jason, Taylan, Matt, Marie, Ken, Norman, and Dan. Guys need to jump on that and get that unlocked for you. Okay, so once you go and get this unlocked, now, once you pay for that and get it unlocked, it sometimes takes a minute or two for it to transition through and process, and then you will see, it'll all of a sudden be unlocked. Sometimes you have to refresh the page, and I've even found sometimes you got to actually log out and log back on, and then it'll be unlocked for you. Okay, so just try those methods, but give it a couple minutes first in order for it to process through. All right, so once you go here to My Marketing, what you're going to do, this is where all of our promotion comes in, is My Links. All right, My Links is going to show you where your links are, where your affiliate links are to promote. Okay, everybody has these. You have a capture page, you have a sales page, and see the link is underneath each one. So for the capture page, it says C1 here. You guys see that? It says C1. Oops, I didn't want to do that. That'll take you to the capture page, that's for sure. Over here, the sales page, it says VSL1, which is Video Sales Letter 1. You go down here, it's the step 1 page. This is the page that a person comes to in the funnel to download their free PDF and also actually get to experience step 1 in the 18-step process. So that is the step 1 link. And then the order form, which is the OFT one, that's the order form. That's where people pay the $1 fee to come into the system. Now, the thank you page is not an affiliate link. It's just a thank you page. This, if someone comes here to a thank you page, that means they paid the $1 and it was processed correctly, that they are now a $1 buyer. Okay, let me see a question here real quick. The video or the sales video page doesn't load. Have tried many times. Okay, try a different browser in your computer. Depends on what browser you're going to. I use Google Chrome, but it should really work in any browser. If you're having a problem with it still, I would highly suggest sending in a support ticket, because that may be a technical issue on that. So Rena, I don't know if I'm pronouncing your name right or not. Miss Markin, you want to make sure that try a different Rena, okay. Try a different browser and see if that works. And if that doesn't, you can also clear your cookies, and maybe sometimes that'll do it. But if not, send in a support ticket and have tech look at it. And it may be just some simple little thing that, you know, maybe the coding is wrong or something on your page, and they can go and fix that for you. But you definitely want that working before you start promoting, okay? So make sure it's working for you. All right, so typically when we advertise, we are going to advertise to what's called a capture page. And the reason for a capture page is, if you look at, all right, here's a sales page here, all right? So I go to my video sales page. It's where the video starts. Okay, and Michael starts talking here. You can go directly to the $1 offer, etc. It has all the information about the Digital Altitude program. So you can scroll through here, read it all, and so on. But why don't we, during a paid advertisement, why don't we send people strictly to a video sales letter to show them the product? The reason being is that if we showed them this page, if we sent them here to this page, okay, and they looked at it and they said, wow, that looks pretty cool, but let's say they're at work and the boss starts coming by, boom, they click off their internet, all right? Well, now you paid for that person to be there, all right? You paid for that click, they got there, they may even been interested, but they had to bounce off really quick, and then now they can't remember how they got there, all right? So you just lost a potential customer. So what we want to do always, now granted, I guess they could go back to their email if that's what they did, but maybe they saw it on a link on Facebook. And, you know, Facebook, the news feed changes all the time. Sometimes whenever you're really interested in something, it's impossible to go back and try to find it. So let's say they came through that. They can't go back and find your link to click on again. The reason we send them to a page like this, which is called a capture page, and there are actually two of them inside Digital Altitude. There's this one here, and they rotate between each other, and this one here. So see, if I click on it once, I get this page. If I click on it another time, I get this page. If I click on it again another time, well, sometimes it's a random rotation. All right, now it's going to be picky on me. There, I get this page again. So it's just random, but you have two different pages that are working for you. But the reason we send people to this kind of page is we want their email address. And you all know about the emails, and so on. You know, once you put in your email address, you're going to receive a follow-up series of emails. All right, that's how marketing works. And the reason we do that is if you didn't buy right away, we want to keep putting the product in front of you. We want to keep driving you towards the product. We don't want just one shot at it and that's it, because that would be very expensive marketing, okay? So we want to have, you know, we want to make sure that people are putting in information that we can follow up with them. So when they put in their email address and then they click on, let's see, I'm going to have to change this because it's going to recognize it. So let's put... let's do 4434. I submit this, and then I go to the video sales letter. So someone asked me a question here is, do you have to load all of the pages? No, you don't. These are built into a funnel. So Diana, when you use the capture page, if someone opts in like I just did, they opt in, they're going to go to the video sales letter. If they're in the video sales letter and they say, you know what, I want to go further with this. I want to get that free download or whatever. So then they're going to turn around. They may either do it at the bottom of the page, they may do it in the middle of the page, or up here at the top of the page, and they say, I want to get started now. So it's going to take them to the order form. If they finish through that video, the video is going to take them through the step one. So let's say they're at the order form here and they're not quite sure yet. They can go here and watch the video. This is going to take them to step one. This is where they can download their free information and also watch the video. And then again, they still can go back here to the order form. All right, so all of these pages are linked together in what's called a funnel. And so you're just driving people through the front door and let the funnel do the rest of the work. Okay, so hopefully, Diana, that answered your question for you. The only thing you got to give out or promote is your affiliate link to the capture page. Okay, now when would I not use the capture page? When would I use a different page here? So let's say I have all these choices of pages, and the only time I'm going to suggest to you that you would use either the video sales letter page, or you would even use the step one page, or possibly even the order form directly, is someone you know. Someone you have made a personal connection with, whether it be on Facebook, you know, whether it be a family member, whether it be a fellow employee or coworker, whether it be, you know, your neighbor next door. If you're talking to someone about this program and they have opened the door and they say, hey, you know, I'm interested, I'd like to know more about it, then I usually am either going to send them to the video sales letter or the step one page. Typically, the video sales letter, if I haven't talked to them a lot about it. If I've talked to them a lot about it, then I may send them to the step one page to check it out. Okay, so I'm going to send them to one of these two pages. Now, so I would grab that link, and that's the link that I would use. Now, one of the things, and I'm going to get into tagging here now. Hold on a second. I got to move some stuff around here. Okay, so when I do tagging... So one of the things that I've done, and I'm going to show you here, this is kind of my cheat method here. I went ahead and just copied all of these links out of my back office, and I just put them onto a notepad in my computer. So I have all of these links already here, and I've gone in and I've labeled them all, so I know which link is what, although obviously you'll always know by looking at the VSL one, step one, C1, etc. That's going to tell you capture page, sales letter, step one page, order form. Okay, but what I would do is, let's say that I was going to, let's say I was going to send this, I have a client where I have a person on this webinar here, Dan LeClaire. Okay. So let's say Dan and I were chatting on Facebook, or we knew each other as coworkers or something. And so I tell Dan that, hey, Dan, I'm gonna send you a link for you to check it out. So I'm gonna send him to the video sales letter. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tag the back of this link. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because, one, I wanna know if Dan ended up clicking on the link or not, because I'm gonna follow up with him in a few days. So what I would do is I typically would put like D for Dan, and then put LeClaire on here. So LLAIRE. All right, so I would use this link, and that's what I would copy. I would test it first. So I go over here to my browser, and I want to just click, paste, and go here real quick. I want to make sure that it picks up. So it sends them right to the video sales letter. And if you look here, though, let me stop this. All right, if you look here, this is, and I can't make this larger here, but here is my Aspire link for the video sales letter, and it has D. LeClaire on it. All right, so I'm going to know whether he clicked on that link or not. So let's say he watched that, and let's say he went down here further, read through the whole page, and said, you know, I'm not sure, I want to know some more. And you get all the way down here, sorry if I'm making people dizzy here, but you get all the way down to this very long video sales letter. And let's say that, you know, Dan says, you know what, I want to know more about this. So I'm going to go and I'm going to look at the privacy policy. I want to know what is their privacy policy here. And I want to know their terms of service. You know, what really is involved in this company. And really, you know, you hear all these people making all this money, but I want to see their earnings disclaimer. These are all things we're required by law to put on these pages, okay? But here's their earnings disclaimer, and, you know, and if all else fails, Dan wants to know, hey, if I decide I don't want this, I want to know what is their refund policy, you know, because sometimes companies will put, like, this little catch in there that really you don't get a refund, you know, you got to read the ultra fine print with the microscope. So I want to know what the plain and simple refund policy is. So now I can go back up here in my Digital Altitude back office, and let me shrink this down for a second. I can go here to my campaigns, and because I didn't send Dan to an opt-in page, I'm not going to have him as a lead yet, but that's fine. The purpose of being a lead is so that we can follow you up with emails. Because we don't know you, we're just trying to get you to like our product and buy our product. But I know Dan. I already have a way. He's either my neighbor, he's my friend, he's a fellow coworker, or we know each other on Facebook, whatever. I have a way of connecting with Dan again. So I don't need his email address. I already have it, or I already have a way of connecting with him. So I'm not going to find him here in the leads, but where I may find him is, let's see here, what was that? Where I am going to find him, or no, I'm sorry, I'm not going to find him in conversion chat because he didn't buy anything. So where I'm going to find him is my page view. So I'm going to know whether he actually looked at the system or not. So I can go down here. Remember the tag that I gave was Dan LeClaire. And now look at this here. Let me enlarge this. I can see from here, all the way down to here, Dan looked at the earnings disclaimer, he looked at the privacy page, he looked at the refund policy, he looked at the terms of service, and he did look at the video sales letter. So if Dan's going to spend that much time looking at stuff, I know Dan is very interested. Dan is looking around and he's very interested. Now, what I would hope on there is that Dan would have also visited the order form and would have also had a thank you page in there. Because if you see a thank you page, that means also that the person, like here, if you see a thanks, then that means that person bought. Okay? And that person then is going to show up under your conversions. So they're going to show up as a member, and they're going to show up as to whatever your commission is for that. All right, so if it's an individual, like, let's see here, let me find an individual. All right, so here was an individual that came in, and I tagged it. I tagged his name. Now, he only came in, he only did the $1 offer, okay? So I made a whole 43 cents off of sending him the link directly, okay? But I can also go back in and look at all the pages he looked at. And let's see here, let's go back and find that tag. All right, so here's the tag here. So you can see he went to the order form, which we know he went, he got a thank you page, which I know he paid the dollar. He looked at the refund policy and he looked at the Digital Altitude company itself. All right, so I can see all the different pages he visited. Now, granted, I only got 43 cents out of him, but you know, you got to look at those things and say, hey, 43 cents is better than nothing. Okay, he decided he didn't want to go further. He tried the $1 offer and didn't want to go further. But he at least tried, which is great, okay? So you want to be able to track that. So you guys are starting to understand the purpose of tracking, because tracking, putting that tracking link on the end of your affiliate link, and you saw how I did that. Let me go find my affiliate links here again real quick. Move this stuff out of the way. All right, so I can put whatever tag I want to. So let's say the purpose of tracking, I'm going to run three solo ads because our webinar here is based on solo ads. So I'm going to buy three solo ads from three different vendors today. If I don't tag, and that, remember the link that I'm going to use is my capture page. So I'm going to use my capture page link. That's the link I'm going to give them. If I don't tag, then what's going to happen is all of those clicks are going to register here. You see this here where it shows there's no tag? So there were 44 unique visits. You don't worry about the visits. You worry about unique visits. There were 44 unique visits. There were three leads out of that, and there were three members out of that, and I earned $388.01. Okay, now if any one of these members ends up becoming a Rise member, or if they became, because I'm an Apex, if they became Ascend, Peak, or Apex, then this commission level is going to, you know, shoot up, okay? But the problem with it is, I ran an ad to three different vendors at the same time, and I don't know what vendor worked and which one didn't. So if I'm looking at it going, hey, okay, you know, I made some money, I want to do that again, the problem with it is, if I go back to all three vendors and place the same order again, if I had tracked this, if I had put a tracking link on here, I may have found out that, you know, vendor A was the one that gave me all the leads and all the members and gave me the commission. And vendor B and C just sold me clicks. So they just cost me money. I got no return on my investment. So that's why you have the importance of tracking. You have to track. And this tracking will follow people all the way into your earnings. If you go over here to your earnings, it's going to follow people. Come on, load up page. Takes forever to load up. It's going to follow people. You can see the tag right here. You can see a tag right here as to where these people came through and the commissions you earned off of it. Okay, so the tagging is important to do. Usually if you don't see a tag here, like in my area where I don't see a tag, this is because it's a tier two, which means it had a different sponsor that brought him in. This is a sponsor that I have as a member. They brought in another client. So it's a tier two commission. You can also see your team here under my tree, and you can see your different levels of people. So like I have three Apex members. And under my three Apex members, these are the members they've so far brought in. Now, if their members start bringing in people, I'll see three layers deep. All right? So I don't want to get off track here, but that's how that system works. So again, with solo ad marketing or any kind of marketing, unless you're using your own capture page, you're going to send them your Digital Altitude capture page link because you want to capture their email information. Okay? So let's see here. I have a quick question here. I'm a Rise Walker. Do I need to link autoresponder to capture page? Okay, so if you don't currently have an autoresponder, we have the autoresponder for you. So if you use this capture page, people end up in the back office, and they show up as a lead for you, but we're providing the follow-up series of emails. Okay, so we're the ones emailing them through our customer relationship manager software, which is like an autoresponder. Okay, so you don't have, if you don't have the autoresponders, you don't have to have them right away if you're promoting to our pages. Now, if you're promoting to, you're building your own pages, your own capture pages to go into your own autoresponder, then yes, you have to have that. Okay, there is a way if you are a climber member, you can also link your autoresponder so that you can use the capture page. All right, so you can use the digital altitude capture page, but the people actually end up on your Get Response, AWeber, or PT Sender now. This is a new one that they just added here. So you can link your Get Response and AWeber to your digital altitude capture page, so you don't have to build your own. The lead goes into your autoresponder, and then you have the auto, you have the 18-day follow-up series that you can load into your autoresponder. So you would just follow these instructions here. Now the key with it is you have to use, let me enlarge this here, you have to use, if you're using the digital altitude capture page and you are sending them to your AWeber Get Response or List Send autoresponder, you have to use the My List AWeber link. So you're not using the Aspire.link, you're using the Aspire.me capture page, and that is just coded so it knows to send people to your AWeber account, and then it goes back over to the video sales letter. All right, now I want a show of hands real quick. I got everybody's hands down. How many people are climber members here? Okay, a few of you are climber members. All right, good. Okay, so I'm going to lower your hands. So now the next question for you is, how many people have linked their autoresponder to digital altitude? Okay, looks like a few people have. And are you using the Aspire.me links to promote with? Raise your hand if you're using those links. Okay, good. All right. Now, the thing I will tell you, all right, is, and in fact, I don't want to confuse you if you're not doing it. If you're building your own capture pages, but you're sending people to, let's say, your AWeber or Get Response list where you've already preloaded those 18-day follow-up series emails, if you are not using this, see if I can make that larger. If you are not using the Aspire.me link because you've built your own capture page, or maybe you're using the OSP sales funnel, or maybe you're using Mac Mill's sales funnel, if you're using anything but the Digital Altitude Aspire.me capture page, you have to work on those links inside the 18-day follow-up series. Okay? And not to confuse everybody, but it's actually critical. Because if you don't use, if I send people to my AWeber list that I've loaded those 18-day follow-ups in, but I do not use this Aspire.me link, I'm using my own capture page, then the links inside where people land on the, where people are getting the follow-up series emails, if they're in those emails and they click on one of those links, you potentially will not get the credit for the click, because the page will work correctly, but you're not linked to it. They only work if you're using that Aspire.me link. So I'm going to give you guys all, and I'm going to include this in an email as well, but I'm going to give you guys here a video, and I'm going to load this in the question areas and also in the chat area. So I'm going to give you guys a video here, and I would highly recommend, again, anything I'm putting here in this webinar, you need to make sure you copy it right away, because once webinar is done, this is all gone. okay? But this this little video that I made here shows you how to change out those links. And it's real simple to do. It's a little time consuming, but it's simple to do if you follow it step by step, but you need to change those links. If you're sending people to that AWeber or GetResponse campaign, and you have not changed those links, and you are not, I repeat, you are not using the Aspire.me capture page. You're using your own or someone else's, meaning another funnel, like you know, OSP or Mac Mills or someone, you know, you're creating your own or someone else created one for you. Those links inside your follow-up series will not work properly. They will not credit you for the sale. And that is incredibly important. I just found out about this probably a week or two ago, and that's why I made the video. So I would highly recommend watching that video. If you're already doing that, watch that video, go in and change those links. Okay? It's going to be crucial to you. Okay? So hopefully you guys understand that and get that through. Okay, so let's see. So hopefully, Eric, I answered your question there. Let's see, you just add anything to the tag, no extra coding or anything. That is true, Natalie, it's anything. Again, when I do this, let's say I'm gonna go to a solo ad provider, and this solo ad provider is called Joe Solo Ads. And today I'm gonna buy 200 clicks. So this is how I would tag. Now you can come up with any system you want. I like the KISS method, the keep it simple, you know what. So I was a firefighter, everything had to be simplistic for me. So the way I would tag my link before I sent it out to the provider, I'm gonna go to Joe Solo Ads. So I would put JSA for Joe Solo Ads. I would put the number 200 because I'm buying 200 clicks. And then I would put today's date. So it's 8/18/16. So that is my tag. So it's very simplistic. So if I saw this appear in my back office here, I've got some samples here. If I saw this appear in my back office, then see, like here, I did another sample on another, I was instructing another student, but here it shows up. So I can see that this person, this is a fictitious email, but this person came in, and it came in from Joe's Solo Ads from 7/27/16. Does that make sense? Hopefully that helps you out, Natalie. But again, remember, you're going to record it here. So I would put, you know, if that's the ad I'm running, I would put JSA 200 8/18/16. So I know where that person is coming from. And that tag will follow them all the way through. It'll follow them from a lead. It'll follow them from being a buyer. Okay, so if they buy the $1, if they then upgrade, you're always going to see the tag that was attached to them. So it makes it very easy to go back to this tracking sheet and update the revenue that's generated. Each time a new sale comes in under that tag, that's more money. You just need to update that that number, and you're going to be able to tell when you go here to my conversions, you're always going to get a running total. Let me shrink that down a little bit. You're always going to get a running total on that tag. They'll always be a running total there. So it's pretty simple as long as the tag is individual for every ad. So for every ad, you're going to make a new tag. So let's say next week I'm going to go back to Joe. You know, he did really well for me, and I'm going to go back to Joe, and I'm still going to buy another 200-click ad. So again, I'm going to use JSA 200 because it's Joe Solo Ads 200 clicks, but I'm going to buy another ad from him next week. So let's say it was on the 25/16. So that's how I'm going to tell the difference. I don't want to just put, you know, Joe Solo Ads or Joe Solo Ads 200, because if I buy multiple ads, I want to know what ads are working and what ads aren't. So each and every time you give out your link, you want to put a new tag on it. Now, if I was putting a post, let's say I'm putting the tag inside, let's say a Twitter tweet or a Instagram post or a Facebook post, I may put, let's say it's a post for today on Facebook. So I may put FB and a P for post, and then I would just put, you know, 8/18/16. Now, let's say I run three posts in a day, and all three of them happen to have an affiliate link on it, which they wouldn't for in my case, but let's say they do, then I would just put like an 01 or an 02 or an 03. So that if someone clicked on one of those links, I'm going to know which post did they come in from. And this is crucial. I mean, some people are like, I don't care what post they came in from. They came in, I'm happy with that. But if you can start experimenting or start collecting the data and realize that, okay, if they came in on post one versus post two or three, what did I do different on post one versus two and three? You know, what was different? I can look at all three posts and go, that one, I did this. Well, now I'm going to start doing my posts that way all the time and see if that makes a difference. Because why are they ignoring posts 2 and 3 or maybe, you know, 2 through 10, but they happen to click on number 11? What made them click on number 11 if it's a promotion post? You see what I'm saying? But if I don't track it, I'm not going to know. And if I only track that I'm buying ads from Joe's solo ads, I'm not going to know which ad worked and which ad didn't. All right, so tracking is incredibly important. Putting someone's name on a link before you contact them again, you're going to know up front whether they actually opened that link or not. You know, so you're going to know right away when you contact them and they say, well, no, I'm not interested. Well, you never even open up the link. How could you be interested or not interested if you never even looked at the product? Okay, so, you know, there's when I kind of challenge someone. I'm not rude about it. You know, again, I don't care. If you're not interested, hey, great, more power to you. I'll move on to the next person. But what I'll do is I'll challenge them a little bit, and I may ask them, hey, did you see that point in about the middle of the video where Michael said XYZ? That's why you should know that video. You should know that sales page. And if they don't know that, well, no, I don't remember that part. Oh, okay. Well, you know they don't because they didn't even watch the video. But you can mention a couple things, maybe a couple things on the sales page, you know, and see if that entices them. I've actually sat there on a conversation on Skype with someone that I gave the link to, and we're discussing it because I said, hey, I'll contact you back in a couple days. I did. I knew they hadn't clicked on the link, but what was funny is during this conversation, because I was asking them questions, and they knew they hadn't looked at it yet, all of a sudden I refreshed my page, and guess what? They went and clicked on the link now. So my whole conversation at least got them to click on the link. All right? So now they're looking at the offer. And I've actually made sales that way because I challenged people a little bit. And my parting gift, you know, if someone says, you know what, absolutely, I'm not interested, you know, please, I don't want to know anymore or anything. Okay, great. I usually end them with, you know, well, this really isn't for everybody. You know, definitely not anybody who's in an employee mindset. You know, I'm, you know, it's really meant for people who are an entrepreneur, have a business mindset, who really want to grow and stop working for other people. And that's kind of my last challenge to them. I've actually brought people back into, you know, looking a little bit further into it because they're like, well, I'm not an employee mindset. You know, they don't think they are, but they are. You know, so I've had to work with them a little bit. So, you know, that's ways you can work with people, but reach out to them if you want to. But you definitely want to tag everything. Tag everything you're giving out. If it's a sales page, tag it. If it's directly to an order form, tag it so that you know they looked at it, okay? And then you can follow up with them. And always leave them with, if you're giving it out to someone personally, say, hey, Dan, I'm going to check back with you in a couple days. Is that okay? I don't ever personal message someone and say, here's a link. You should go test it out. I don't like that. What I'll do is if someone is on my Facebook and we start personal messaging each other, you know, I may find out a little bit more about them and I wait for them to open the door for me or I'll ask permission for me to send them a link. I don't just send people links to things, okay? Let's see here. And again, Natalie, hopefully that answered your question. You don't have to code anything or anything like that. When using Igor Solo Ads and he is making a capture page, do we still tag it? If you're going to anybody and Igor is a solo ad provider, if they're giving you or they're making you a capture page, if anybody else is making you a capture page and what they're asking for is usually when someone else is making you a capture page, what they want from you is either your sales page or sometimes they want directly to an order form. Whatever link they ask for, if they ask for your sales page, and this was from Rena, if they ask for your sales page, then what you're going to do, yes, you're going to put a tag on your sales page. Okay, so you're going to hand them the link and tag the sales page link. So you know where those people are coming from. Okay, so hopefully that answered your question. If they ask you for just the order form page, still tag it. Anything with that T and that equal sign, there is a tag you can put at the end here. Because what this is saying is this question mark DA is I'm a DA affiliate equals, this is my affiliate number. Oops, I didn't want to do that. This is my affiliate number, the OA632, and then where it has the end T, that's end tag equals, and then it's set up for a tag. So I can go in and tag it so I can ID it, okay? Let's see here. Also being a walker, right. I'm not sure, Eric, what you're talking about. You may want to elaborate a little bit more on that. Let's see here. Can you use different capture pages other than those still link and link it to DA? Yes, you would have to link it, though, to the sales page, the step one page, or the order form directly. You don't want to use another capture page that you've created or someone else has and then send them to a capture page. Okay, so once you have a capture page already built, whether it's DA's or someone else's, then you're going to send them to the sales page, step one, or order form, depending on, you know, how the capture page is set up. Okay, so hopefully that answered your question. But you can send them back into the system. But usually if you're using your own capture page, you have to have your own autoresponder. So if you use your own capture page, the email address has to go somewhere. And because you're building your own or someone else built one for you, it's got to go to your own autoresponder. Okay, and then from the autoresponder, they go back to the sales page, step one, or order form, whichever one you want to start with. If you go with the sales page, they will automatically go to the step one. They'll go through the sales page to the step one, to the order page, to the thank you. So the funnel will still be complete. Okay, so hopefully, Chris, that answered your question there. Okay, my hand isn't down, but I'm not a climber. Okay, all right, that's fine. That was from Laura. I would highly recommend, guys, if you're not a climber, you know, why pass up that extra commission? You know, if you can, become a climber. It's really not that much more in the grand scheme of things. It's not that much more. All right, Dan, you're going to be one tonight. Very good. I talked you into it. See, I should get commission on that sale or something. Let's see here. Become a climber tonight after this call. Very good, Matt. All right, it's what I like to see. I mean, why pass up? That's free commission, guys. And also, it can be pass-up commission, depending on what level you're at. So, all right, can you, and re-asked, can you add leads to your list in AWeber? So I think what you're asking there is, let's say I have people here in my back office, and I have all these leads here. Can I add them to my AWeber? Nowadays, you really can. What you would do first is you would export this list, okay? So you would put it into a comma-separated file or like an Excel spreadsheet. You would grab just the email addresses because it's going to show you everything here when you export the list. You want to grab out just the email addresses. Then you're going to go to your either your AWeber, GetResponse, or whatever, and you're going to upload that file to them. Now, what they're probably going to require you to do is they're going to require that an email goes out to these people from your AWeber, GetResponse, or whatever supplier you're using. An email is going to go out and it's going to say, hey, Ree wants to add you to her list in AWeber. Is that good for you? And they have to confirm it or not. Sometimes you can get away with them not confirming it, or what you can do also is you can manually put them in. Usually the autoresponders allow you to put in 10 at a time, but if you put in 10 today, 10 tomorrow, 10 the next day, 10 the next day, I guarantee you they will suspend your account because they're going to find out, why didn't you just upload the list? So if you put in, like, you know, 10 of them today and a couple more tomorrow and waited a couple days and put another 10 or 12 of them in, well, I think it only allows you 10, you put another 10 of them in, you know, to where maybe if you had 100 leads, you put them in over a week and a half's period of time, you probably won't have a hassle from your autoresponder. But if you try to do them 10 at a time manually, they're gonna look into why you're doing that. Best thing to do is just give them the list and let them send out the email, confirm the opt-in, and then you'll have the people on the list, okay? Or another thing that you can do is, you know, take them into groups and personal email them, but you want to entice people to come and sign up for your list. So, I don't know, offer them a free ebook or something like that so that they come and opt into your list. But, you know, that's how you can get them over there if you want to. All right. Tope, you are so lost. I apologize for that. If you're brand new to this, you may be very lost with this. Here's another thing I'm going to give you guys here. All right, so real quick here, and then I'm going to move on to the next thing. Everybody understands the tagging. They understand the tagging and tracking on that tracking sheet. Raise your hand if you understand all of that. Except for Tope. I think Tope is pretty lost. Okay, good. Got a lot of hands going up there. All right, good. All right, so about 45% of you, 50% of you now have your hands up. Okay, good. All right, so Tope, I don't know where you're lost at. If it's more of you are, you know, not familiar enough with your back office or what. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give everybody a recording here, also, and I will include this into the emails because I always do. But I'm going to put it right here in the area. Okay, and you're okay. So Gary Johnson, you're totally lost also. Okay, I'm sorry. That was private, so you may not have wanted to have your name announced there, but sorry about that. Okay, so this is a couple things that I'm going to show you here. This webinar here, this was the very first webinar that I did. This was a webinar for just your basics in your back office, tagging and so on. So definitely go back through that recording, and that will get you to understand, you know, a little bit more, kind of go back over your back office, how it works and so on. It's pretty simple to go through. Another thing that I would highly recommend, and I will put this in the I'll include it in the email, let me see here, I'll show that to you in a second because we're getting ahead of ourselves. So real quick, okay, so for solo ad providers, what you're going to do, let me grab my list of solo ad providers here. Let me grab one of those solo ad providers, and I'm going to show you what you're going to be doing here. So let's say I'm going to go to let's see here, I want to go to that. Okay. Oh, we've moved. Okay, redirecting. All right. Okay, so this is a solo ad provider here. So what you would do is you would go to their page, and you're going to scroll through here, and every solo ad provider, I'll tell you right now, every solo ad provider will all have testimonials, okay? I would highly recommend, you know, just kind of go through the testimonials with a grain of salt. I'm not saying that people lie on the testimonials. It's just you don't know what product they were promoting. So whatever their results are, you're not able to compare them to what are your results with digital ads to. The only way truly you're going to know what your results are on an ad is when you run the ad. Okay, and I'm going to go over a few rules here for you also when it comes to running an ad. So go through all the testimonials. You'll come down here to the packages that they offer. You'll scroll down to what package you can afford. Now, one of the things that I would recommend, and I'm going to put all this in the chat area, and I'll include it in the webinar as well. These are the rules that I follow when it comes to dealing with a solo ad provider. So let me close this down here real quick. So the first thing is I make contact with the solo ad provider. Okay, let me enlarge this. Come on. All right, so the first thing I do, so you guys can see that, everybody can see that hopefully. The first thing I'm going to do is I ask the solo ad provider questions. So I look on their sales page. Usually if you go down here near the bottom, now you see here he's telling you that if you want to, if you have a question or something, you can either contact James here on Skype, on Facebook, or you can email him. So usually I use the email. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to send out a series of questions, okay? So the questions I'm going to send out is, and this is before I bought anything. There are two reasons for the questions. One is I want to know what the customer support is like. Because if they can't answer questions for a potential customer, what do you think they're going to be like if I have a problem with my ad that I've already paid for? How responsive do you think they're going to be then? okay? So I kind of eliminate a problem before it even happens. So what I'll do is I'll send out questions, and you know, the first question, you can rewrite these questions, but the first question that I will post in here, or the first question I put in there, and I send them all at once, and I'm going to post these real quick, guys, on the chat and the questionnaire, so you guys can copy those real quick. But the questions I'll ask is, have they ever promoted the Digital Altitude product before to their list? I'll also send them a copy of my affiliate link and also the video sales letter. So the capture page and the video sales letter, so they can see what the product is. Then I'll ask them, what do they feel that this would be a good fit for their list? You know, and you, a good provider, if they don't feel the product will work with their list, they'll tell you. And yeah, they're turning down money, but you know what? Yeah, I would rather have them tell me and not deal with them for that product than I would pay the money and lose my shirt on it. Okay? So then the next question I ask them is, what is the time frame for the ad to start running? So in other words, if I bought it today, you know, are you a couple days out? Are you a week out? Are you a month out? You know, when will my ad run? And then from there, once the ad does run, it's a two-part question. How long does it take for the ad to come in? Okay, so Gary, I'll send you those questions via. I'll send you all of this information via email, but you got to email me requesting it. So everybody, go to my email address, and you can do it right now. Just say, hey, I want the recording for tonight's webinar, which is Thursday night's webinar, solo ads, and I will send you everything that I'm currently sending you guys right now. Okay, so just send me an email, and that's to rarmstrong@digitalaltitude.co. Okay, great. No problem. Everybody got to start somewhere, Gary. No problem there. So the other question I'll ask them here is, how long does it take for the ad to actually run? So if I'm buying up to a 500-click ad, typically that should take you about 48 to 72 hours. Once the ad starts running, that ad should be delivered. If they're trying to tell you that it's going to take a week, there's two red flags right there for me. One is either their list is very inattentive and they got to hammer away at their list, which usually then the quality of that list is very poor, or they're farming your link out to someone else. So they're kind of working as a broker and they're using other solo ad providers. I don't like that. So if they tell me it's going to take more than a couple days for a 500-click ad or less to run, then I just stay away from them. Then the next question I'm going to ask them is, what is the highest price point their list has purchased? What I'm looking for, I don't need exact numbers. I want to know, you know, have they promoted Digital Altitude, MOB, Empowered Network, some of the other big products out there? That's what I'm looking for, because their list is used to spending money. If they say, well, typically my list always wants like something free, you know, they want a free ebook or something like that, and they really don't buy much, you know, the highest priced item they've ever bought is like $7. That's definitely not a list for you, because what you have to think about when you advertise, you are really, you're looking for a $2,000 buyer, okay? You're not looking for that $1 buyer. You're not even looking for a $37 buyer. You're looking for a $2,000 buyer, because that's where you start turning your profit. You know how many $1 sales you would have to make to even pay for an ad, or how many $37 sales you would have to make to pay for, you know, that ad. I mean, it's way too many. You're looking for, I mean, granted, you're getting those $1 sales, you're getting the $37 sales, but you're really looking for that person that can afford $2,000, okay? So if it's a list that's used to getting free things, it's a list I don't want to go to, all right? I want a potential of a $2,000. Then I'll ask them also, do I have to write the ad copy for the solo ad, or will they provide it? One of the things I will tell you guys is that 90-95% of all solo ad providers now write the copy for you. Okay, they don't allow you to write the copy, and if you do, they're just going to pitch it anyway and use their own copy. And it's realistic. The reason for that, they're going to write a very generic email. They know what will get their list to open up and potentially click on your link. But the other reason they write the emails is because they are going to put you in a rotator. They have to survive as a solo provider. You have to have rotators these days. And what that means, and it's not anything bad, what that means is, let's say that Tope buys a 100-click ad or a 200-click ad, and let's say that Natalie buys a 1,000-click ad, and that Marie buys a 2,000-click ad because she's used this provider, she wants a big ad, And but this provider knows that every time they send out an email, they can get consistently 10,000 clicks out of every email they send out to their maybe 100,000 person list. So they're not going to send out an email for a few thousand clicks. They want to get 10,000 clicks. So the way the rotators work is if Taupe is only buying a 200 click ad and their link is up first, then as it goes through the list and as people open up that email and as people start to click on those links, their rotator, their tracking software is going to say, okay, Taupe received 200 clicks, and then it will shut off Taupe's link. So Taupe's link no longer works. Then it rotates over to Natalie's link, and Natalie bought 1,000 clicks. So once Natalie gets all 1,000 clicks, her link shuts off, and then it rotates over to Marie. And once Marie gets her 2,000 clicks, then her link shuts off, and then it's to the next person until they get up to their 10,000 clicks. Or however many clicks they can get. So it's just survivability of a solo ad provider, and I fully understand it, and it's nothing wrong about it. It's just how it works. So the day of writing your own solo ad are far gone. Okay, nowadays it's all rotators, and they write a generic enough ad, but it's still in the field that they're not out writing an ad for, you know, a dietary supplement, and all of a sudden the person's landing on Digital Altitude, because they're not going to get a click on the link. So they're writing an ad that will fit your marketplace. It's just not going to be an ad that says, hey, Digital Altitude, click here. So that's why at times you get the clicks, but you have to weed through those and get a certain percentage of opt-ins. Okay? So hopefully that makes sense. So those are the five questions I'll ask them. I send it out to them. I'll introduce myself. Hey, my name is Russ Armstrong. I saw your sales page. I'm interested in some traffic from you. I just had a few questions real quick. I've listed five questions here. Could you get me some answers? I would greatly appreciate it. You know, I listed the product that I'm promoting. You can take a look at it, you know, and see if it'll work. All right. So I send out that email and I wait about 2 or 3 days. And then if I don't hear back from them, I'll send them out a second email and I'll say, hey, you know, I contacted you about 3 days ago. I sent you an email. These are the questions I was asking. You know, could you please get back to me? It's real imperative because I want to be able to buy from you. But I need you to respond back to me in 48 hours. Now I'm giving them a deadline. And if they don't respond back in 48 hours, move on. Go to the next provider. Eliminate the problem before it happens, because if they don't want to talk to a potential customer, they're going to be really bad when it comes to a problem with the ad. Okay, so save yourself the aggravation and go away from them. All right? All right, so another tidbit I'm going to tell you guys real quick here, and I know it's going to be recorded. One day this company is going to come after me. If you have been approached by HQ Solo Ads, a company called HQ Solo Ads, and I rarely ever badmouth any company directly, but I will definitely badmouth HQ Solo Ads. They prey on a lot of new people in the affiliate marketplace, especially in our area. They preyed on them in the last company I was with, and they do it now with the Digital Altitude clients. If someone from, usually they personal message you on Facebook, if someone approaches you from HQ Solo Ads, do me a favor, stay as far away from them as you possibly can. Their quality of traffic is absolutely dismal. It's terrible. You may as well go out back and burn the money. Just burn it. All right, just start a fire with it and burn it, because that's about what you'll get back in revenue. Okay, and that's if they actually deliver the ad in completion. Usually customers, clients that I'm currently dealing with that have used them before they got a hold of me and realized they shouldn't be using them, there are people that have gone on for months having problems with them, trying to get their money back or trying to get their ad delivered. And even if you end up getting the ad delivered, it's complete crap anyway. Excuse me, it's complete trash anyway. So just heed my warning. Stay away, and they've been preying on a lot of Digital Altitude folks. Somehow, I think there's a couple members of Digital Altitude that promote it. Usually, it's young ladies that personal message you and tell you what good quality traffic they have and so on. If they're from HQ Solo Ads, just stay away from them. All right? That's just, I never badmouth the company, but them, I definitely do, because they have taken thousands of dollars from people and just not delivered anything. All right. So now, after I've delivered the questions, let's say I get my responses back and I'm ready to buy. Let's say I went to, and we've gone well over an hour here, folks. Let's say I've gone to I've gone to, you know, I've asked, I sent out questions, let's say, to 12 solo ad providers, and out of the 12, I got 8 of them to respond back. And out of the 8, 2 of them were low ticket offers, or they always want free things. So I eliminate those off my list. So now I'm down to 6 providers. So now what I'm going to do is I have to test. So the first thing I do is when I run a test ad, I run it for 2 to 500 clicks only. Okay, I don't buy over 500 clicks, because if my ad fails, that gets really expensive really fast. Okay, because see over here, 200 click ad here, and this guy's pretty reasonable, $98. If you bought more than 500 clicks, now you're up into $282. You're up into $368, $414. So you see what I'm saying is if you run an ad and it fails, that can hurt your budget real quick. So 2 to 500 clicks. The reason I don't go below 200 clicks, and some people will sell 100 clicks, it's not a large enough ad. It's not a large enough sampling of their list. And usually these small ads will fail. Okay? They're just not representative of their list. So 2 to 500 clicks only. If you're going to test multiple, I would just stay in the 200 click range, 200, 250 click range. So you can spread out your wealth amongst a few different providers and test them all. See which ones work well for you. Then you go to, I only go to top tier countries, and it's nothing against other countries. It's just the value of their currency to the US dollar. You got to realize everybody's buying everything here in US dollars. So if you end up in countries that, you know, we're looking for a $2,000 buyer, you end up in some countries and $2,000 could be a quarter of your salary for them. So you're never going to get a $2,000 buyer from them. You may get a $1 buyer from them. You may even get a $37 buyer from them from, you know, 1 or 2 months going, but there never is going to be any longevity there. So I would prefer having my clicks go into the hands of people that potentially could afford it. So I stay within the U.S., Canada, New Zealand, Australia, and United Kingdom. All right. And with solo ad providers, you may look and see, you know, read their sales page. Sometimes they offer different packages to top-tier countries. Sometimes they'll offer you percentages, and I'm not sure how he has his broken down here. Okay, so here's our top-tier countries. So if you look here, see if I can enlarge this for you guys. Okay, move that out of the way. Okay, so right here he does top-tier countries. So 61% is US, 10% is United Kingdom, 6% is Canada, and 2% is Australia. All right, so these are the top countries that he's going to, and he gives you information. You know, it can take up to 2 weeks after the time the order is accepted. So read through the sales page. They're going to give you a lot of the information right then and there as to, you know, maybe even who they have promoted before. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. But, you know, read through the information. So I want to go 2 to 500 clicks only on my test. I want to buy within the top tier countries. And then what I'm looking for when the ads start coming in is I am looking for a 21% minimum opt-in rate. That means out of every 100 clicks I purchase, I should get 21 people giving me their email address to look further. All right, that's pretty low, but that's the lowest I want to go. All right, what I'm really looking for, hopefully, is, you know, 30, 40, 50%. But the key thing is I'm looking for a 5% conversion rate. That means buyers, from leads to buyers. Because I could have a 70% opt-in rate. I could have, out of every 100 clicks, 70 people give me their email address. But if no one buys, that still costs me money. I make no profit on that. All right, but if I had a 21% opt-in rate and I had a higher than 5% conversion, which means out of 21 people, one person buys. Let's say I have a 10% conversion rate. That means out of 21 people, two people are buying. Then that is starting to make me some money. Okay, because at the end of the day, we want buyers. We don't want leads. We want buyers. I mean, you have to collect leads first to get buyers, but ultimately you want buyers. I would rather have a list of 1,000 people that buy than I would have a list of 10,000 people that don't buy anything. Okay, because you're in business now. In the business comes from a customer. A lead really is not a customer, it's just a lead. They're not a customer until they pay money for your product. Okay, and at the end of the day, that's who we're looking for. All right. Now, if you get good conversions, you get the minimum standards that you're looking for, then what I always recommend, and this is where I'm going to share with you where I used to make my mistake, and I spent thousands of dollars being ignorant about this, is I would go from, let's say, a 200-click ad, and I would have good results, and I'm like, hot dang, I'm going to now, you know, if it was this good at 200 clicks, wow, what is it going to be at 2,000 clicks? So I would turn around and I would buy a 2,000 click ad, and the ad would flop. And, you know, at a 2,000 click ad today, and this was years ago, back when ads weren't as expensive, but if I went up here to a 2,000 click, I just spent almost $1,000. And that ad just failed. So unless you have an unlimited budget, that can hurt real quick. That can affect your budget really quick. So if I buy a 200 click ad and my numbers are good, I repeat that. I will buy an exact same ad, another 200 click ad. I do not change one thing. I send the ad out again and I see if the numbers hold true. If the numbers hold true, then okay, then those are good results. Now I'm going to increase it, but I'm going to ramp it up. I'm only going to increase it 2 to 3 times. So let's say I bought a 200 click ad. After I've tested it twice and my numbers are still good, then I may increase it to 600 clicks. And then from 600 clicks, I may increase it to 1,000 or 1,200 clicks. And then from 1,000 or 1,200 clicks, I may increase it up to, you know, 2,000 clicks. But you see, I'm ramping it up, and I'm always monitoring my numbers, okay? And that is important because I learned the hard way. Don't be a gambler. Don't be the all-in guy at the table, you know, holding a pair of twos. You know, do it smart. Work smarter, not harder, and make your money work for you better. Okay, so ramp up your advertising, just like in Facebook advertising, any kind of advertising, you do your testing, and then you start ramping up from there. And monitor your numbers, because eventually the numbers start to fall down again. And when they start to fall down, don't run another ad until you figure out why. And a lot of times when you're at a supplier, the reason the numbers start coming back down is because you have burned out that list. And that sounds bad, but what's happened is you've run too many ads too soon or too short a time apart from each other. What I always recommend is when you're done testing and you've tested several different providers to see who works for with your product and who doesn't, you know, or what ads are successful and what ones aren't, and you've double tested them, then what you want to do is create like 4 core providers. So these are 4 providers that work very well with your product, give you good results, they give you leads, they give you buyers, everything is right in the world, okay? So what I'll do is I'll take those 4 providers and let's label them, you know, provider A, B, C, and D. So then what I'm going to do, so I don't burn out any of their lists right away, is I will go week 1 to provider A, week 2 to provider B, week 3 to provider C, week 4 to provider D. So by the time I'm coming back up here to provider A, I've given provider A 4 weeks to replenish their list. So when my ad runs again, there's a lot of new eyeballs that my ad is running onto. Does that make sense to you guys? You've got to give time for the provider to rebuild their list, because they're constantly rebuilding, but if you hammer away at a list, eventually they're going to get tired of your product, or they're going to get tired of your capture page. So that's in turn where it helps at times. You can use the same provider, but change up your capture pages as well. Show it to the same people. It's just a different way of showing it to them. But you're in reality, you're showing them the same information. So I'm going to put all this information here in the question area and also in the chat area. So that has all of the rules of buying solo ads. So hopefully, let me lower everybody's hands. Does everybody get what I've talked about so far? Everybody understand what I talked about so far? Okay, raise your hand if you do. All right, I'm looking at 33, 45, 50, 50%. Looks like 50% of you at least understand. 54%. All right, we're cranking along here. Okay, so good. I know, like, you know, for Tope and for a couple other people, they were just like completely lost on this. It is a lot of information, so that's why I get the recording so you can go back over it and kind of in pieces and review it a little bit more. The thing about it is the last thing I'm going to tell you about a solo ad here is when you pick the package you want to deal with, so let's say we're going to go with a 200-click ad. I'm going to click on this, and what this ad is going to do is this ad is going to take me to, typically it takes me to PayPal, all right? And so I log on to PayPal, and then I will pay for this ad, right? And I'm not going to buy this ad for you guys just as a demonstration purpose, but it's going to show me, you know, how much I need to pay for the ad, and I click on buy now. Then what it's going to do is it's going to redirect me. Once I've purchased it, it's going to redirect me over to, and I just closed down this page. It's going to redirect me over to an order page. And the order page, you just fill out the information it requests. When it asks for your link, you're going to go back over here to your digital altitude. Actually, I got to shrink this down. You're going to go back over here to your digital altitude. You're going to go to your links. I'd actually have this ready beforehand, but you're going to go over here to your links. And if you're sending them just straight into the digital altitude system, you're going to copy this link here, and you're going to put a tag on the end of it. So like that was James Jordan. So I would put JJ. I was going to buy 200 clicks. JJ 200, and I would put 8/18/16. So I would know exactly when I bought the ad, how many clicks I bought, and who I bought it from. So that's how I would tag the link. All right, and so that's what I'm going to put on there. And that's the link I'm going to give him in his order form, and I'm going to fill out whatever other information they want, and then I'm going to submit the form. And then you'll get a reply email back saying, hey, we received your order. Then you know, your ad's going to start in 2 weeks or less. Okay, great. We're done. We're ready to go. If there's a problem, if you submit that order form and there's a problem with it, like you forgot to include your link or something, they will email you and say, hey, you know, you ordered these, but you didn't give us anything to run the ad to. And so they'll email you. So make sure you're putting an email address that you constantly look at those emails, and then just reply back, you know, go find the link and go. But just, you know, make sure before you submit it, review the form that you just filled out. Make sure all the blanks are filled in and just submit the form. Okay. So hopefully that's going to help you out there. All right. So Natalie, good. You got it. Makes perfect sense. Good. I'm glad, Natalie. That is great. Let's see here. Okay. On the webinar that you do twice a week. Yes. Marie, I cover the same topic. So what she's asking is I do two webinars a week. I guess I'm glutton for punishment here. No, the reason I do two webinars is if you go here to the live coaching in the back office, you'll see that I do a Thursday 9 p.m. Eastern webinar and a Wednesday 1 p.m. Eastern. The Thursday webinar is like tonight's topic is solo ads. So this next Wednesday at 1 p.m. is going to be solo ads. Now they're both live webinars. I do not play a recording on the second webinar. So the information is the same. Sometimes it's presented maybe a little bit different because it's based on some of the questions people ask. But the main topic and the information overall is the same information. It's just there's no way I can completely duplicate. I don't do most of my presentations are not by like PowerPoint slides. I call that death by PowerPoint. Some of my presentations do have slides, but most of them are just live presentations. I like that because I can interact with my webinar attendees. If they have questions, I can answer those questions and keep the ball rolling. Okay, so hopefully, Marie, that answered your question. But yeah, you can come and watch the solo ad one next Wednesday at 1 p.m. We just did the Wednesday one because we had people in the UK that for some reason, I don't know why, they didn't want to stay up till 2 a.m. to listen to me ramble on about a webinar. All right, so we created an afternoon one Eastern time because for them it's then evening and it makes it you know, acceptable for them to be able to go on. So you can join those at any time. And if you join any one of the webinars and it's a topic you're not interested in, just click off. It's no biggie. I mean, you didn't have to pay for the webinar. They're free. And you know, you're not going to hurt my feelings. But, you know, don't, you know, if it's something you're interested in, stay on the webinar. If you're not, hop off the webinar and go enjoy your evening. Go out and, you know, have an extra glass of wine or something like that. Enjoy your evening and you don't have to sit here and listen to me ramble on the webinar. So, let's see here. Okay. All right. All right. Let's see here. What might you say in a Facebook post? Natalie, do me a favor. Ask me for the recording of this webinar and send me in your email that you send me, ask me for the Facebook training, because I just got done with a 3-part Facebook training, and that will discuss what you would put in Facebook posts and so on. Okay, and that'll go in a lot more detail versus us going off on another bunny trail and talking about a different topic. So Natalie, just send me the email and ask for that. How do you get organic or free traffic? With a lot of work. You know, nothing is free in life. I will tell you that right now, Diamond. In order to get organic, now I get organic free traffic from my Facebook page, I get it from my blog site, I get it from my website, but you got to realize that it took me a long time to build those audiences up. So if you want to, you know, they'll tell you, hey, a blog site, you can get free organic traffic, that's great, but if you created the best blog site today in the world, best blog site, everybody would want to be on that blog site and read your blogs. But if you don't have a client base yet, how do people know your blog even exists? You're going to have to get those people there. So how do you get them there? Typically, it's through paid traffic. So it's just building the relationship up with people. You can do it through your Facebook pages. That's one free method. Instagram, there are some free methods. But the problem with it is even Instagram are not free, because you to make Instagram really work, you use products like Follow Liker and so on. Those all cost you money. You want to make your own capture pages. Those all cost you money. So in essence, even if you're not paying for actual traffic, you're paying for a lot of the tools to get you the free traffic. So I typically in these webinars, I'm not going to be covering a lot in the realm of free traffic. It's mainly paid traffic. This is to get people up and moving with their business. You got to realize in a business, businesses cost money. And you paid to have the privilege of being able to sell a product that was already made for you and so on. But you got to get people in front of the offer. Now, free ways you can do it is go and, you know, you can make up flyers, put them on local bulletin boards saying, you know, partners wanted for an online business, inquire here and leave an email address. You can work that way. You can go out and put flyers on people's windows. You can, you know, go to the grocery store and start handing out flyers, you know, if you want to. Just talk to people. Get out and start talking to people. Go and talk to your friends and your family and business associates and neighbors and so on. That would be a form of free traffic. But you know, a lot of people don't want to do that. They want to deal with the anonymous people. If you're dealing with cold traffic, meaning complete strangers, usually it's paid traffic. It's the only way you're going to reach them. All right? You're welcome, Diana. I'm glad I was able to answer your question there. Let's see here. I'm sorry, Chris. I was able to answer your question there. All right. If I have the Aspire autoresponder linked to the links, also being a walker, I need to be in a higher level. Okay, I'm not sure, Eric, if I'm understanding that correctly. You're a walker level, and right now you're using the Aspire, or I mean, you're using your affiliate links in the back office. They are tied to the back office autoresponder. If you're building your own capture pages, then you would have your own link to bring people in. If you had your own autoresponder, then you would have to connect it back over to, like, let's say, the video sales page. So I'm not really sure if I'm comprehending what you're talking about. I'm just recommending for anybody, be a climber. It's not that much more a month, and you have the capabilities of as a climber that, you know, not only do you earn the commission, one, you can earn a total of 60% commission versus 40 as a walker or 50 as a hiker, but you can earn the 45% commission on the person you bring in. And then if that person brings in someone, you automatically earn 10% commission on that. And if that person brings someone in, you earn 5%. So that 15%, you didn't even have to work for. That's 15% commission off of everything they sell up to the level you're at that you didn't even have to work for. That's free money. So, you know, if you can afford it, then I just recommend going to Climber. So, all right. So, Chris, you got it. All right. Didn't understand how the autoresponder worked. Could you go over that one more time? Okay, so the autoresponder inside Digital Altitude is already built in. So as soon as you bring someone in on this capture page, okay, they're going to go to what we call your back office. They're going to go into the Digital Altitude Autoresponder. So they're going to appear in your back office as a lead, and Digital Altitude is going to be sending them an 18-day follow-up series emails. Every day for 18 days, they're going to send them an email. And the email is going to keep putting the product back in front of them. Okay, it's differently written emails, but it keeps putting the product in front of them. There are links there, and because they're tagged to you, as soon as they click on the link, you get the credit for that sale. Okay, so that's what that's all about. Hopefully that explained it to you, Rena, that's how the autoresponder works. If you have your own autoresponder, then that's a whole different ball game. There's other things you need to either create your own follow-up series or load the follow-up series from Digital Altitude into your own autoresponder. But the key is any autoresponder, whether it's yours or whether it's DA's, autoresponders are in the whole purpose of them is as soon as someone comes into that system, they're immediately receiving an email. That's why it's called an autoresponder. Okay, so you want to make sure that, you know, even if you're using your own autoresponder and you don't use the Digital Altitude follow-up emails, you got to start building up emails, and I guarantee you don't want to do just one or two. You want to have at least 18 to 30 days in there because you want to keep putting that offer in front of people, okay? Marv, missed the first 55 minutes. Marv, send me an email. You know how to connect with me now. Get me an email, and I will send you the recording of this as soon as I get it loaded up tonight. So, but send me an email because I'm not going to remember. My memory is about 5 minutes long, so once I'm done with this email, I'm going to go grab dinner, and then I'm going to finish loading up the video here. Let's see. Thanks, Dan. I appreciate that. Dan was saying I should receive the commission. If he's going to go up to Climber, I should receive a commission off that. I'll have to talk to Michael about that. I don't think that's going to fly, but all right. So Tope, I have a suggestion for you here. I'm going to show it to you in just a second because you're still completely lost here. I've never been in the back office. Okay, Ken, you need to get to the back office. So grab one of the recordings that I gave you there, which is the back office basics. And that will give you information on the back office, at least an intro to it. Will you be providing us with the entire webinar recording as well at the end? No, because I got to upload this webinar. I've got to strip it down, turn it into an MP4, load it back up, and then I have a link for it. So, Vladimir, just email me, and I will send you the copy of it. It'll probably go out either, well, it'll most likely go out tomorrow morning because it takes a little while for it to upload. So just whoever wants this recording, send me the email and I will send you the recording. Okay? I understand you're lost there. Okay, I have a list of emails. Can I upload it to the company? And no, you can't upload, Anthony, you cannot upload a list of emails into the Digital Altitude system. So if you have a list of emails, I would suggest get your own autoresponder and then just keep sending them. You know, if you want Digital Altitude to follow up with them, get them into an autoresponder and keep sending them your capture page link. So as soon as, if anybody opts in, now Digital Altitude will send them the follow-up emails. Okay, but you can't, there's no way for you to take that list and just load them into the system. We don't allow you to do that. Okay, can I demonstrate? There's no way I can. I don't have the time. We're almost at 2 hours. I don't have the time. If you want to know, if you have an autoresponder, Anthony, and you are wondering how to upload or how to import into your autoresponder, a list of people, just go to your autoresponder, go to the help area. I know with GetResponse and AWeber, they have some excellent tutorial videos, and just query the question, how do you upload a list? And they'll show you some videos on how to do it. It's pretty simple to do, but just follow their instructions. All right, because really right now, all I could show you is AWeber. I don't use GetResponse or MailChimp or anything like that, where there are other people that do, and so I couldn't show you their method. Just follow their instructions within the autoresponder. Okay, so Ricardo, you're very lost. So I have a possible solution for you here, Ricardo. Okay, let's see here. I'm just finishing up these questions here. Oh, good. Okay. So, Marie, good. You got approached by HQ Solo Ads. Yes, turn them down, guys. Remember, if you, and one day they're probably going to turn around and sue me, but I have proof on how terrible they are. So, bring it on. I will blast them away in social media. I'll kill them. Let's see here. Vanessa. Okay. Oh, good. You have, Ed, you have Vanessa. Very good. She's an excellent coach out of the UK. Good. She, yeah, all my coaches pass on the 200, the HQ solo ad stories. So, all right, good info. All right, great, great. All right. Okay, I've been expecting where. Yeah. So, Jason, again, just send me the, send me an email, and I'll send you the copy of this webinar. All right. Thank you very much. All right, what's the website you are using for PPC? The website I use for, well, the website I use for PPC, I do, I'll tell you guys right now, majority, probably 95% of all my marketing is all done in Facebook. So yeah, I'm not sure really, Justin, what you're talking about. The website that I use, I only use Facebook. I mean, that's primarily my main goal or my main go-to place for marketing. I have an ad agency, and we are on Facebook all the time. So for other clients and brick and mortar businesses and so on. So I don't really even have time to go to a lot of other places. I know how to do other advertising. I just don't use a lot of different methods. So I'm not sure what you were asking there, Justin. All right. So I was supposed to get a traffic coach, but I haven't received one yet. Traffic link is still locked. Can you help me? I'm a Rise member. So, Diana, again, look at you either have to have finished your 18 steps or you, again, have to activate that affiliate link. So, Diana, send me an email with this information on it. I can look it up and see why, if you were supposed to get a traffic coach, why you haven't. But it could be that if you came in as a Rise member after July 8th, we don't give traffic coaches directly one-on-one traffic coaching to Rise members after July 8th. Because there were just too many of them, and they clogged up our system. So that's why we enabled the webinars and so on. So send me an email, Diana, and we can figure it out. All right, great. Okay. So is new information presented on Thursday night? Yes. Every webinar is going to be new information. So it's either going to be a multi-part series because there's so much information, I have to spread it out over a few webinars. Or it's going to be individual webinars, but it will always be new information. Okay, so, well, not always. Maybe 3 months from now, we may be repeating some information, but for now, it's all new information. Okay, because we have a lot of different topics to discuss. So hopefully that helps you out. Okay, yes, we do the training every week unless something, ungodly happens, like we had 2 weeks or 1 week total. Where I present, I live outside of Spokane, Washington, and we had I live in a community outside of that, the big city, and they did construction that day, and they cut our DSL line, which whoop, there took my internet away. That's the only problem with internet marketing. Your business comes to a screeching halt if you no longer have internet, and I can't run down to like a McDonald's or something and do a webinar that just doesn't have enough bandwidth to it. So because I have a business line that comes into my house, so. We were not able to do that Thursday, so we had to postpone it a week. And then, of course, the next Wednesday, we weren't able to do that one because someone in their infamous wisdom changed all of the logon information to the GoToWebinar account from Digital Altitude and gave me the wrong information. So when I went in an hour before the webinar and went to log on, I couldn't, and we couldn't track down the person to make the change. So by the time we did, it was like 2.5 hours after the webinar was supposed to air. So, that didn't work. So that was a really a bad week for webinars. But typically, we will have a webinar once a week, and then we have it, Thursdays and Wednesdays is a repeat of the webinar. All right. Yeah, Rena, if you want all the recordings of any webinars we've done, just ask for that because I read every email. So if you just say, hey, I want Thursday night's webinar, I'm only going to send you the recording to Thursday night's webinar. And the information I gave on Thursday night. If you say, hey, I want all the information, I will, because all I do is copy and paste, so I will copy and paste all the information to you. Just ask for it. and I'd be more than happy to. I just don't want to keep repeating the information for people, but just ask for it, and you know, I'd be more than happy to give you all the recordings. Okay, so let's see here. We have all right. Where is the link to register? So if you want to register for webinars, any of them, go here to training, and go down here to where it says live coaching. And from there, you will see the Thursday and the Wednesday webinar. So you can go to either one of those. They'll take you to the registration link. And it's the same link every week. So the Wednesday registration link works for every Wednesday. The same Thursday registration link works for every Thursday. Okay? So hopefully that answered your question, Laura. Are the webinars different topics each week? Yeah, I already answered that. They are. Suppose traffic coach, haven't received one yet. Okay, so Diana, I told you to email me. I know some of you guys have repeated questions here. I got a lot of questions here. So let's see. Once you post a capture page, do you need to create the sales page link? No, if you're using the Digital Altitude capture page here in My Marketing, if you're using the capture page here, then this is tied to the sales page. That's tied to the step one page. That's tied to the order form and then the thank you page. So the funnel follows. The only thing you have to do is give them the link to the capture page. If you gave someone a link to the sales page, it's going to tie into the step one, the order form, and the thank you page. So they all are tied together. It's just wherever you're starting with. So hopefully, Jason, that answered your question. Okay. What is the email for you? Okay, so again, the email is rarmstrong@digitalaltitude.co. So rarmstrong@digitalaltitude.co. prong@.co. So I'm going to put this back in the question and also chat area so you can, because I know it kind of got buried down in there. So Brandy, go ahead and make sure you grab that and just send me the email, okay? Let's see. All right, so Diana, I just sent you that. Well, it's in the, I just sent it to there. All right. Good. I'm glad the daily phone calls. Yeah, if you guys are going on the daily phone calls, you need to get on there. I'm usually coaching, so I don't get to go on there very often. So how do we get hold of Lewis? If you're interested in the past webinars, and again, we've only got so many of them. I've got like four webinars. Just ask for them. When you email me, just ask for them. I'll send you every webinar I've got. Okay, you're welcome. All right, make sure your email address is rarmstrong@digitalaltitude.co. No, it's digitalaltitude.co, not tudes. So there's no S at the end, and it's .co. So hopefully you got that, Norman. I put it back in the message area again. All right. Thanks, Natalie. Appreciate it. Jason. Yeah, no, it's not com. It's co. So, Norman, it's co for co. It's not com. A lot of people make a mistake, and they put com on there, and then they wonder why the email gets bounced back. All right? All right, guys, so I think we're out of questions here. We have gone a long time tonight, a lot further than I thought we were going to go. When will I be able to actually start marketing? Well, Matt, as soon as your affiliate links are unlocked, you can, you know, hammer away at it. The key thing is you got to have that marketing unlocked. You got to have access to your affiliate links. Once you can get to this page here with your affiliate links on it, you can go out there and market to your heart's content. Okay, so now we've given you examples of how to run a solo ad. If you watch the past videos on Facebook marketing and so on, you have a couple different methods that you can start using. If you have friends or coworkers or someone that you want to give a link to, once those links are available, knock yourself out. Go get them. All right. All right, thank you very much, Dan. I appreciate that, and I expect to see you go to Climber. All right, thanks, Ed. I appreciate it. Diamond, appreciate that. All right, guys, good. I'm glad, Laura, that you enjoyed the webinar. All right, perfect. Well, I aim to please, so I'm glad I'm getting some thumbs up here. All right, guys, so I'm going to call it an evening. We've lost a few people on the webinar here. Thanks for hanging in with me, and we will get you that information. Please just email me, and I will give you all the information that I've sent here to you, and be able to repeat that information. So just send me an email. I will get all this information to you, and I'm going to bid you goodbye and have yourself a good night or a good day, whatever part of the world you're in. And we will talk to you maybe next Wednesday or Thursday. So I'll talk to you guys later. Have a great weekend coming up. Be safe, and we'll see you next week.